Blackstone presents Aliens vs. Predators, Rift War, by Weston Ochse and Yvonne Navarro. This book is read by Kate Rudd. To Zachary Ochse, because there is no better son. Prologue. The Ovomorph pulsed with life. Writhing within the amniotic fluid was a creature perfected by an unknown hand eons ago. Then the Yautja encountered them, harnessed them, and found a use for them. Now the creatures were bound to the Yautja system of honor and the hunt so thoroughly that the two species would never be separated. This egg, in all its hideous beauty, was the beginning of a cycle that would help transform a young Yautja into a strong and valued member of their society, as he or she began to fulfill their destiny. Seeding a planet for the unblooded was the first step in the developmental process. The source of the Ovomorphs remained hidden behind various impenetrable levels of bureaucracy and wasn't deemed necessary for those who were to become future hunters. During the downtimes, however, traveling between the stars, Arwen couldn't help but wonder where the creatures had originated. Xenomorphs had been their primary antagonists as far back as any record he had found. If there was a time when they hadn't been the Yautja's mortal enemies, their greatest prey, it lay beyond memory and was of no consequence. What mattered to Arwen was that he was here, a shepherd of sorts, whose mission was to provide for others that which they could not provide for themselves. This planet was the fifth one Arwen had seeded on behalf of the elders. Umans called it LV-363. The Yautja identified it as a rift world because the surface was split by deep gashes, as if a giant, zealous juvenile had taken an oversized wrist blade and tried to carve something into its surface. The elders had designated it as perfect for seeding, with a wide variety of fauna that included two- and four-legged mammals, including primates of sufficient size to host the embryos. It also would provide an excellent battleground for groups of juveniles who were ready to become blooded. The rifts would add to the difficulty and create several unpredictable problem sets that the juveniles would need to overcome. Neither the juveniles nor those who were training them would know of Arwen's presence. It had taken time and effort for him to rise in the hierarchy, to the point that he was entrusted with the seeding process. Those beneath him in the training strata weren't privy to his activities. As well, there was another reason for choosing the rift. Senior xenobiologists on their homeworld of Yautja Prime believed that if a xenomorph implanted a species of the local fauna, in this case the winged insectoids, a mutation might emerge. There were those who rejected the theory, but to Arwen it seemed entirely plausible. The winged creatures were at the top of the planet's food chain and had no viable predators. The only exception was a type of microphage that strained the host's endocrinological system, slowing its hunger and keeping it from ranging too far or killing too many of the other species. It was as if the land itself had installed a governor on the insect's ability to flex their superiority over every other life form on the planet. Setting aside his musings, Arwen returned to the task at hand. His mission was always the same. Having prepared the Ovomorphs, he had located the best area for placement, seeded the testing ground, set the beacon, then returned his ship to a hidden location. Once he had accomplished the first three tasks, he opened the manifest that identified those who would participate in the hunt. In that moment, everything changed. Instead of leaving before the blooding began, he chose to stay. The time had finally arrived to settle an old score. Arwen had been waiting for this chance for 15 years, since the day that had ruined his life. The day when the one he'd most trusted had let him down, leaving him for dead, broken on a planet to which he refused to give a name. Because of his many years living a solitary existence, Arwen had become a scholar of all things relating to vengeance.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.